this video, we will describe the clinical case of progressive impairment of the AV conduction in a patient with inferior myocardial infarction. A 56-year-old man was brought to the emergency department with complaints of severe chest pain with irradiation to the interscapular region that has occurred 2 hours before. Also, he complained of fatigue and nausea. ECG was performed. We see ST segment elevation in leads 2, 3, AVF. Also, PR intervals before the first 3 QRS complexes are prolonged. The first PR interval is shorter than the second and the third one. But P wave after the third QRS complex seems to be non-conducted. And the fourth QRS complex is an escape beat. As its morphology is similar to those of previous QRS complexes, this is an escape junctional contraction. The fourth P wave is blocked. It should be assumed that this is the second degree type 1 atrioventricular block, which is characterized by a gradual prolongation of the PR interval up to the non-conducted P wave. The PR interval following non-conducted P wave is the shortest, and then it gradually prolongs to the next non-conducted P wave. This is called Wenckebach periodicity. We would see such classical periodicity if the escape junctional contraction was absent. It's difficult to put the correct diagnosis in this case because of the too short strip. But if we see the rhythmogram, we can clearly see the second degree type 1 AV block with the escape junctional contraction. PR interval after the escape junctional contraction is the shortest. It should be differentiated with the first degree AV block and the second degree type 2 AV block. In the case of first degree AV block, all P waves are conducted. There is a prolongation of the PR interval. In the case of second degree type 2 AV block, the PR interval is constant in all complexes with periodic non-conduction of the P wave. Coronary angiography was performed. Right coronary artery was occluded in the mid-segment. But interventional cardiologists didn't perform revascularization due to an unknown cause. 2 days later, symptomatic bradycardia suddenly developed. There were dizziness and severe fatigue. Recorded ECG showed the second degree AV block with conduction 2-to-1. At first look, this is the first degree AV block on the background of sinus bradycardia. But there are 2 P waves before every QRS complex. First of them merges with the T wave, but in some leads it is obvious. The patient was prepared for the procedure of temporary pacemaker placement. ECG, done 1 hour later, showed complete heart block. It may seem that there is the second degree AV block with a conduction 2-to-1, but in this case, the PR interval is always different. There is no relationship between the P wave and the QRS complex. The QRS complex is narrow, so the ventricular rhythm originates from the AV knot or bundle of His. If the QRS complexes are wide, the ventricular rhythm originates from the ventricles. Often the P wave merges with a T wave and sometimes with a QRS complex. The temporary pacemaker was placed urgently, as there was a high risk of sudden death or ventricular standstill. A transvenous pacing electrode was inserted to stimulate the ventricles at the appropriative rate. Often AV blocks occurring in the acute phase of myocardial infarction resolve spontaneously. And cardiac pacing is not indicated after the resolution of high degree or complete AV block complicating the acute phase of myocardial infarction. Timely, performed PCI may prevent many complications, including AV blocks. Thank you for watching this video. We hope you enjoyed it. If you want to see more of our videos, please subscribe and hit the like button.